Welcome back, everyone. In this episode, we make the flasher circuit. Okay, so we've got everything here. I got my breadboard here already made up, what I want, how I'm going to put the circuitry together, and decided I'm going to be putting it right here in the top portion, and everything here that I need, and the capacitors, which I'll try one by one to see which one I want for the flashing of it. For here I got 1K resistor, 2 10Ks, LM555 chip, socket, and the 3904 transistor. Okay, so I got the circuit board here in a circular pattern, which will go right there. Just like that. Alright, so I got my board here. So I need to. Just gonna solder this in place. I'm a little off center here. Because I need more room in this area here for components. Yeah, let's go here. More than enough. Get my here and please. Okay. Good. Alright. Now next I'm going to be doing the 10K resistors. So I'm going to take it and twist it down so it's in, looks, well, so it's elongated down, so it saves on space. So this in here goes from pin 6 to pin 7. I'll just spread them out just a little bit here just to keep it from falling out. Now I got this here other 10K resistor. Goes from pin 7 to pin 8. that. Pin number 8. Don't need too much solder, just teeny tiny amount. Okay. Resistors there are in place. Now I'm gonna do 1K resistor. And it goes over this side here. So it goes from number 3 to the transistor. So pin 3 to transistor. Like that to look at the transistor in place. Let's see, transistor, where, oh, there it is. Get right up there. Now, according to my breadboard here, the middle pin on the transistor goes to the resistor. Now this is where these come in handy. All the excess pieces that you cut off, you can reuse those. I need to make a line here to pin number 1. That's not quite long enough. But that is so. was going to talk this like that. Okay. I'm just gonna solder the tips. This model. Pin here sticking up, that goes to the negative of the LED. So I'm just going to leave that open. Just going to twist it down just a little bit here. You don't want it touching anything else. Okay, now everything's in place here except for the capacitor. So what I need to do with that is take my breadboard here, and then my capacitors here, and do a test. And I'm just using 3 volts here, that's all I need. Positive. Negative. And you see it's on there because there's no capacitor in here. Now I gotta look at where the zeros are. This is the negative side and positive side. And I need to go between 1 and 2. Oh, that's not long enough. Oops. Okay, that's blinking way too fast. What is that? That's a 2.2 microfarad. That's okay. It's a small one here. It's way too fast. It's on the show when I saw it. It was blinking rather slow. Okay, that's 100 as well, but I'm gonna use a small one just for the simple fact of the size of the compartment. That's 100. There's a 220. A little bit too slow. 100. Okay, looks like the 100 is the one I'm going to use, alright? So I got, and I'm going to put that right here. Whoops. Okay, over here a little bit. negative side goes to 1, and the positive here goes to pin number 8 on that side. Okay, yeah, this is where I'm going to put it right there. Good. Now listen here, negative is here to 1. That's a little bit too long. Just straight. Or just solder the tips. Circuit board there. Next thing to do, put the chip in. And you just gotta make sure the little notch on here matches the notch on the socket here. Otherwise, you're gonna have your chip backwards, which would be awkward. Fit. Still gotta be pretty gentle though. Can't have unnecessary parts here touching anything else that they're not supposed to touch, otherwise your circuit board won't work. Okay. There we go. Here's the completed board. And the mess underneath. Good thing you won't see that. And as I've stated many, many, many times before, don't throw those out. Keep them. Because, man, they are priceless when you're putting together a circuit board. Okay, the only thing left to do is to add wiring for the power, which would be negative, positive, and the wiring, the positive LED goes number 8, and the negative goes on to this little pin arm here of the transistor for negative. I have two sets of colored wiring here. This here is going to be for the power and for the LED, just so I can tell which one is for which. it's always good to have multiple colored wiring. Okay, now, these are obviously way too long. So, shorter. You can use wire strippers if you want. Yeah, just go. Of course, you're gonna make sure your exacto's sharp. Sure, it's the thing's upside down now, so you gotta make sure you remember which one is which side is which. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We'll be right back. That circuit is done. Ready to go. There we go. One thing you gotta remember too is you have to run a shunt between pins 2 to 6 and 4 to 8. And that completes the entire circuit. Oh, and just in case you guys were curious about how I had the camera held in place. The old handyman trick. There you go. Well, that's it for this episode, everyone. I hope you all enjoyed it. In the next one, we're going to start work on the Defiant. So, if you enjoyed it, please like, subscribe, and comment. And I look forward to seeing you guys again next time. Bye-bye.